I'm on Patreon, and Patreon is a platform where I will upload interesting videos where you can learn astrology. And this is an exclusive Patreon only membership videos where you will get some interesting takes on Vedic astrology, some interesting learning on Vedic astrology, which I can usually will not upload on general YouTube platform. So that will help me grow as a channel, and that will help me take care of the cost of production of this YouTube channel and the other two channels that I have, Puneet's Astrology Hindi and Lifetime Soul. Connect with me on Patreon and we will grow, and I will give you much more deep insights on Vedic astrology, and a lot more secrets will be shared there.
Hello seekers, welcome to Puneet's Astrology, your one-stop astro channel. Mars will make its move in the sign of Scorpio on 5th of December. And this is a very significant move because Scorpio is a zodiac sign of Mars, but Mars will encounter Ketu. Now Ketu is said to behave like Mars, but Ketu is a bit reckless, but also a very spiritual planet, a planet of moksha. What will happen when a Mars-Ketu combination, a kind of an Angarak Yoga, will form in the sign of Scorpio? Let's find it out. But before that, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss another update. Follow me on Instagram and my Telegram channel to get quick notifications and much more. Also, if you want to take my consultations, you can drop me an email. The email ID is in the description box below. So let's begin the analysis for all ascendants for Mars transit in the sign of Scorpio. Ascendant number 1, Aries ascendant. Now if you observe that Aries is an ascendant ruled by Mars itself, and Mars happens to be in the 8th house. On 5th of December, Mars will encounter not only Ketu, but will also find Sun and Mercury. Mercury will move quite in a faster manner, move out of the Scorpio, move to Sagittarius. But on 16th of December, that means 11 days from the Mars movement, Sun will also make its move out of the sign of Scorpio. So the first 11 days of Mars transit, Mars will encounter Sun, Ketu together in Scorpio. And then after that, on 16th of January 2022, when Mars moves out of the Scorpio zodiac sign, Mars will encounter Venus in the sign of Sagittarius. For Venus, I've already made a video of Venus transit in Sagittarius and Ashada Nakshatra. You can watch that video on my channel. This 8th house movement of Mars is very, very crucial, because 8th house is also the house controlled by Mars. This is a house of investment, in-laws. This is a house of anything that is associated with uncertainty. And Mars movement in this house definitely shows that you will gain control on the issues that are difficult for you. Also, if you observe Sun, which is the 5th lord, is also in the 8th house, shows speculative business. So maybe you will invest in bitcoins, maybe you will invest in stock market. But remember, Ketu's presence in this house is not good, because this can create issues, this can create a blind investment, this can create misdirected attempts towards solving the problem. You need to wait for Mercury to move out and for the Sun to move out of the Scorpio zodiac sign. And once Sun goes in the sign of Sagittarius, when 5th lord goes into the ninth house, this is a very good placement for Mars to work, because second from Mars will be Sun in a very positive zodiac sign. This Mars, when it is with Ketu, is not aspected by any other planet, but Mars will aspect Jupiter, which is already in the Martian nakshatra of Dhanishta. So this will increase the expectations of life. This will increase your attempt to move. This will increase your attempt to invest. And this will also increase your attempt to take control of the situation. And this is where you will have to be extra cautious. 8th house is not a house that you can joke about. It is also the house where there will be an eclipse on 4th of December, just a day before Mars moves from the sign of Libra. But 8th house is also the house where the maximum ultimate war happens. So for Aries ascendant, I will say that this Mars transit will be kind of a mixed transit. And this will give you both positive and negative results. You will have to be extra cautious. 8th house Mars and Ketu also means there can be a chance of small accidents, a small nicks and cuts. So you will have to be very, very careful, especially while you are driving. Mars 8th aspect on the 3rd house, that means Mars 8th aspect in the sign of Gemini, definitely shows that this force of Mars in the 8th will dominate your own efforts. So the control on the life will not be that the way you want. Maybe there will be a desperation that will come in. Because it is also your ascendant lord, it will impact you the most. So you will have to be very, very careful in this case. In this case, you can chant Hanuman Chalisa every day. Chant Hanuman Stotra, Hanuman Ashtak. You can also chant Bajrang Baan to ward off any negative energy. And on Tuesday, try to do fast and distribute food to the needy. This will stabilize the 8th energy of the Mars. Also, it can have you have to be cautious if you're dealing with public money. And also, you'll have to be cautious with your own health, especially if you are already suffering from any blood-related issue, such as blood pressure or any other issue that is related to heart. Overall, I will say it's not that bad because, see, Scorpio is, after all, the zodiac sign controlled by Mars. So you can say that this will buffer much of the negativity, especially Jupiter in the 11th house will buffer maximum negativity. But still, you can't really play with the fire, because when Mars will enter the Scorpio, the Navamsha of Mars will be the debilitated Navamsha. This Mars will be a bit of frustrated Mars. So until and unless Sun moves and takes control of the Sagittarius zodiac sign, you need to hold on to your decisions. And especially decisions related to investment, taxation, any kind of speculative investment. This also shows that fight related to properties, inheritance can also rise in your family. So you will have to be very cautious here. Fight between brothers should be avoided at this time. This is a kind of a transit where you will have to avoid things and wait for the right time. And wait for Jupiter to buffer things out. Patience is going to be the key for you. Ascendant number 2, Taurus Ascendant. Now in this case, Mars goes in the 7th house. Because Mars goes in 7th house, this will start impacting marriage. Again, you will have to wait for Sun to move out of the sign of Scorpio. Because when Sun will move in the 8th house, it means that the Buddhaditya Yoga that will form in the sign of Sagittarius and the presence of Venus with Saturn will give you certain maturity, especially from your in-laws if you are facing any problem related to marriage. Mars, Ketu, Sun, Mercury in the 7th house is not good for business, so you need to hold your plans or be very careful in any plans that that involves heavy investment. Unplanned business attempts will meet failure at this time. Remember, this Venus, which is your ascendant lord, is also going to be moving to the sign of Capricorn and then will come back as a retrograde Venus, you can see here, in the sign of Sagittarius, while Mars remains in the Scorpio zodiac sign. And this Angarak Yoga in the 7th house can actually turn out to be slightly negative, especially with the circumstantial events, because 7th house is something that you see or observe in the surroundings. This means that you need to be very careful with what you commit, with what you speak, with how you behave in the public, how your body language is. So you have to be slightly cautious about yourself so that your actions or your desire don't hurt people around you, don't hurt the loved ones and the near and dear ones. Mars and Ketu in the 7th house can be easily balanced by helping people who are physically challenged, who are suffering in life. And if you help them, if you give them that confidence, if you give them that boost of energy, it is going to be working in your favor. Again, for you, chanting Hanuman Chalisa is going to be a very good remedy, especially when Sun goes in the 8th house. This shows that the real investment will start working in your favor. Buddhaditya Yoga in the Mula Nakshatra also means that the mental energy will focus towards finding the root cause. So if you are stuck in any task in this time, just looking at Mars and Ketu and Sun and Mercury, I can say that after 16th of December, if you do root cause analysis, you will find the proper solution of your problems. Also, this means that few things can frustrate you in an extent that you would want to change your career. So it is also going to impact career. But because Jupiter is in Dhanush Nakshatra, this change will be good for you. So people looking for career change can actually hope for the best while Mars moves in Scorpio zodiac. Also, when Ketu is in Anuradha nakshatra, movement of Mars in Anuradha nakshatra, and once it crosses over Ketu, as you can see on 16 December, it crosses the degree of Ketu. This will prove beneficial for the entire Taurus zodiac sign, especially people with Taurus moon sign. Overall, this is going to be a mixed transit for you. You have to ensure that you make the best use of it. You have to ensure that you make the right use of energy, and don't waste your energy, because waiting for the events to happen, hoping for the events to happen, can actually make your energies go waste. So when you're investing your time, money, energy into anything, ensure that you are doing it at the right reason, for the right reasons, and you're doing it at the right place. If in case of any confusion, wait it out, wait for the planets to change, especially after 16th of December, and then you will see positive results of the same Mars transit. Gemini ascendant. Now, in case of Gemini ascendant, if you see, Mars movement will be in the 6th house. Now, this movement is actually very good for you, because this movement takes care of enemies. This movement takes care especially anything that is troubling you from the concept, from the part of life, which is any dispute, court cases, any ailment. So Mars and Ketu there, and especially Mars going in its own zodiac sign, takes control of that. It shows a headstrong attitude, by which you will see not only you will get support of the energies in your favor, but you will also be able to cut the problems. It is like you have the weapon as well as the energy to cut the prarabdha karma. Well, this is the time when the prarabdha karma can be paid back for the Gemini zodiac sign. So you will see a lot of relief at this time, but also a lot of compulsive, karma will happen. A lot of compulsive activities will happen in your life, which you will see that you're somehow forced, or somehow you are being pushed into that. So don't worry. Let the sun go into the sign of Sagittarius. When sun will move in the Sagittarius, it will be a Buddha-Ditya Yoga. Sun will give the power to the sign of Mercury. Sun is your third lord, and then your actions will be in the right direction. This is the time when you need a guru. Mars will have fourth aspect on the guru. Mars will need guru. This also shows that Mars and Ketu in the sixth house will try to protect the dharma, and this will become a dharma yuddha. That means you will be put in your, you will be finding yourself in situations where you will have to take the call of fight. You will have to fight for what is right. And one thing you have to make sure, that whatever your fight will be, this fight should be legal. This shouldn't be disruptive. This should be as passive as possible, because Mars and Ketu is like internal inflammation. Talking about internal inflammation, you will have to be very careful about inflammation inside the body, your immunity response. So stress will increase, so you will have to be very, very careful. You will have to manage your stress. Overall, this is going to be a very, I will say this is a positive transit, but you need a kavach for this. So chant Panchmukhi Hanumat Kavach while Mars is in Scorpio zodiac sign. For people who don't know Panchmukhi Hanumat Kavach, you can also chant Bajrang Baan or Hanuman Chalisa. 100 Hanuman Chalisa counting chant should be done while Mars is in Scorpio zodiac sign. So it's like a cumulative chant for a month, and you will see a lot of relief. People seeking new loans should avoid any new loan at this time. And just because your enemies, you will win over enemies, doesn't mean that you will create enemies. So be humble, because the more humble you are, the better the Saturn and Venus will work. And because Venus will create a Vipreet Rajyog once Venus goes in the sign of Capricorn, you will see a positive side of this Mars transit. And you will also gain a lot of control on the situations of life, the difficult situations of life. But Ketu's desperation shouldn't kick in, because it will be a misdirected missile destroying your own self. So don't do any activity, what you say that don't spoil your own home. And with proper understanding of the situation, if you go slow, you will see that you will be in exactly right placement, right position. Cancer zodiac sign. Now for this, you see Mars is in the 5th house. And after 16, Mars and Ketu will be alone, and Sun and Mercury will be in the 6th house. So with Mars in the fifth house, you can say this is very good for career change. This will also be good for people who want to learn. Mars and Ketu will meet Sun and Mercury in Jyesh Nakshatra. So this means that you will understand the responsibilities of your life. You will be able to carry forward and you will be learning a lot by execution of karma. You will also love doing things for other people because of Venus and Moon combination in the sixth house. Mars will also aspect the Jupiter in the eighth house. The only thing that you should not do is boast your ego, boast your knowledge, show your pride on the things that you know and the things where you are expert. Because fifth house is the house of education as well as Purva Punya. Ketu means something that is incomplete. So this Martian energy is incomplete. That means before you can actually reach the ceiling of the knowledge, before you actually achieve something, you will start celebrating. So premature celebration is going to be deadly, is going to be harmful, especially in your career. And for students, you should give double revision. You should try to focus more on your studies and chant Ma Saraswati Mantra. With Mars and Ketu in the 5th house and Sun and Mercury in the 6th house, people going under divorce cases, people going under the custody of the children will face a difficult scenario. So in this case, you will have to wait for the Sun to move out of the Mula Nakshatra's first pada. That means you will have to wait till 21st of December, and then Mars will also move ahead, and then this Mars will gain more control on the 5th house. Because see, when Mars is approaching Ketu, it is going for a kind of an eclipse. There is no eclipse on Mars, but this is an Angarak Yoga. But once Mars goes ahead of the Ketu's degree of 6 degree 12 minutes, as you can see, it happens on 16th of December, this will start creating the separation. For the Cancer ascendant, the movement of Mars and Ketu happens at a time when Moon is in Moola Nakshatra. This means acknowledgement of responsibility is going to be the key for a successful Mars transit for you. Yes, Mars is in his own house, 10th Lord is in 5th house, it is a Raj Yoga. It shows change of career, it shows you going into a totally different livelihood, it shows that you will follow your passion, but it also shows that your attempts to express yourself will not meet the criteria and will fall short of the expectations. Because of the Ketu in Anuradha, you will have to give up the target and you will have to follow the path. It's like you need to enjoy the journey more than you look for destination. It's like you are in a train and you're enjoying the journey. The train will automatically reach the destination as long as you have boarded the right train. For you, chanting Hanuman Chalisa and remembering Hanuman, going to Hanuman temple is going to be a very key to resolve any issues of Mars and Ketu. Leo ascendant. Now in case of Leo ascendant, if you see, Mars moves in the 4th house along with Ketu. Now because Mars is with Ketu in the 4th house, 9th Lord going in 4th house definitely means change of home, change of property. But because it is a Mars-Ketu combination, and especially after 16th of December when Sun moves into the 5th house, you will have to be very careful while you're driving. Don't do any reckless driving. Also, it shows reconstruction of properties in your own home or buying a new home. People who are looking to sell their property, sell their car, sell their flats are also going to benefit by this Mars transit. Once Sun goes into the 5th house, your ascendant lord will start gaining the power, because right now Sun will be in the Jyesh Nakshatra, Mercury is cumbus, Sun will be under the influence of the eclipse. So you will have to wait for Sun to become powerful. So you will have to wait for your ascendant to become powerful before you can resolve any issue or take control of situation. Mars and Ketu in the 4th house shows an imbalance between work-life balance, just because Rahu will be in Kritika in the 10th. So you will have to put some efforts towards maintaining your health as well as work-life balance. You will have to wait for Mars to move out, because when Mars moves out to the sign of Sagittarius, it will meet Venus, which is your 10th Lord and your 9th Lord. So definitely this shows a good change of career, a good change of fate, especially with people who are unhappy, who are feeling unhappy. On the overall analysis on a very generic scale, you will feel that you are not destined. You will feel depressed to a certain extent because your destiny house, ninth house, and the happiness house, Sukhbhava Lord, Mars joins Ketu. So the best way to handle this is to simply surrender yourself. Right now, devotion and surrender will keep you happy, will keep you content. Otherwise, you will keep on trying, you will keep on attempting to change your life and you will end up gaining nothing. So this is the time when you only do the karma and don't think about the results. Just surrender to the God and you will get positive results. So for you, it is karmanyevadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. Virgo Ascendant. In case of Virgo Ascendant, Mars will move in the third house and it will join Ketu, Sun and Mercury. So you will have to ensure that you should not fight with your brothers, because Mars and Ketu in the third house shows that some dispute with your brother, with your friends and with your neighbors. When you are going for a small short distance travel somewhere near, you will have to maintain utmost precaution. You will have to maintain all possible, you will have to follow all protocols and ensure that your arm does not take a hit. Because Mars and Ketu in the third house, see, Mars and Ketu means rust in the iron. So any cut in the hand can prove to be dangerous. So if you first of all try to avoid working with any tool that has rust, and in case you have, don't ignore it. Go to a doctor, maybe possibly take a tetanus injection. Third house also means house of communication and effort. So Mars and Ketu means your communication will not be able to, you will not be able to portray the words in the right manner, and you will try to talk, you will try to communicate, but possibly your communication will not reach. Ketu's sucking energy will take away the essence of the communication, and maybe choosing the wrong words can land you in trouble. For that, you will have to wait for Sun to move in the sign of Sagittarius, because Sun and Mercury in the fourth house brings power to the Ascendant, because your Ascendant is of Mercury. Venus gives you common sense. When it comes with Saturn, acceptance is going to be the key. Now Mars and Ketu in the third house also means that you're using excessive force. Excess of anything is bad. So this can put you into a situation where you are going into a fist fight. You will have to be very, very careful. Use of force is actually not good when Mars is in the Scorpio zodiac sign. Overall, I will say that this is the timing where you are more meditating. You are using your force more internally. You are using this power to empower yourself by addressing the weak areas of your life and then focusing on the stronger areas, improving the stronger areas and working on the weaker areas. Because Ketu is more like internalization and Mars is recharging your own battery, rejuvenating yourself. Also, people doing gym, people doing exercises should be very careful, because Mars and Ketu can actually create some tension in the tendons, joints, that can hurt you. So you'll have to be careful. Overall, this is going to be a life-changing, because you will want to forcefully take some decision that will transform your life. Because 8th Lord in the 3rd house, but with Ketu, shows desperation. Don't act in desperation. At least wait for Sun to move in the Sagittarius zodiac sign, because then Mars will move into Virgo Navamsha, which is basically the Navamsha associated with your Ascendant. So wait till that time and then you will see a positive results. Patience is going to be the key for you. Libra Ascendant. In case of Libra Ascendant, Mars will move into the second house. Mars and Ketu presence in the second house definitely shows some event in your family. Mars and Ketu in the second house only shows that there can be heavy expenses, especially it can be expenses because of marriage, it can be expenses because of your spouse, it can be an expense where your business takes away some funds. So when you are utilizing your own bank account, your own bank balance, your own savings, family savings, then it shows that the circumstances or peer pressure or status, all these things can can create a dent in your bank account. So you'll have to go humble. Remember, your ascendant Lord is also going to hover between Sagittarius and Scorpio zodiac sign. So that means when Venus goes over Saturn, it shows control of Saturn on Venus, which means you will feel trapped. In order to get away from this trap, you would want to simply change your environment. Maybe a vacation, maybe something exotic, luxury. Everything is fine, but ensure that you do not go on overspending, because Mars and Ketu in the second house in Anuradha Nakshatra shows following. Maybe somebody told you a good location, a good resort, but you can't afford that one, and you have taken credit cards and you have taken loans. So don't go overboard, especially from the finances, because Mars and Ketu can create a dent. For this, you will have to pray to Ma Mahalakshmi. Chanting Shri Sukta every day is going to be very much beneficial for you. And you will have to wait for Mars to move in the Sagittarius zodiac sign, because when Mars will move in the Sagittarius, that's when the seventh Lord and the second Lord will find itself in a good position. Because when Mars for Libra ascendant is in Sagittarius, especially out of the Mula Nakshatra's first pada, Mars is second from second. It's a Bhavad Bhavam position for Mars. So for you, Mars transit in the Scorpio zodiac sign, although it is the own zodiac, just because there is Ketu and there has been an eclipse in this zodiac sign, the energies are financially not great. Now, second house is also the house of speech and food, because it's a house of mouth. So you will have to be very careful about what you eat. Eat low calorie food, cut down on carbs. This is the right time to go for a diet. This is the right time to lose your weight. Also, Mars and Ketu can show a really harsh speech. Be very careful with what you are speaking. It can pinch somebody. It can hurt somebody. Also, don't curse. Don't use cuss words, because that energy will come back to you, especially when Sun will move in Mula Nakshatra. These words can put you into difficult situations, especially in your career. Seventh house means circumstances. So circumstance-based things can happen. Maybe some influence on the family can create some tussle in the family. Be careful. It's just that you have to manage and handle the situation rather than giving it a full fight. Overall, this is an average transit. This is a mixed transit for you. Yes, because of Ketu, if you show signs of humbleness, if you show signs of patience, then you will see that Mars will show the results of Scorpio zodiac sign. You will have to wait till the end of December for Mars to give you some positive results. For December month, I will say this is 6 out of 10. But for January, I will rate this Mars transit as 8 out of 10. So that's how it goes for Libra ascendant. Scorpio ascendant. Now, in case of Scorpio ascendant, Mars will move on your first house. In fact, for you, it's a very good transit, because at least your ascendant Lord comes back to the ascendant. Ketu in the first house was actually giving a lot of confusion, and this was creating, split personality, low in confidence, and Ketu in the sign of Scorpio is very mysterious. So this was creating the confusion about your own self, your own personality, your own existence. Once Mars comes into the Scorpio zodiac, it brings back your old self in a new form. So it's like you have to shed off the old self. You will have to let go a few things about yourself, and you will have to be ready for the change. You will have to accept the change. Once you accept the change, Mars will give you a lot of positive results. This Mars is also going to work along with Jupiter to stabilize your life. Jupiter in the fourth house gives you the understanding of happiness, understanding of knowledge. Saturn in the third house stabilizes actions for you. Venus and Moon in the second house brings love for you, compassion. And Mars in the first house brings out the new identity within you. So I will say this is a very good transit, especially after Sun movement into the sign of Sagittarius. First of all, people will start supporting you. You will see that you are now in a better control of the life. You are now in a position where you can take decisions that will favor your future. It's the right time to decide on your future. You can plan 2022. You can plan your year ahead, and things will move in the positive direction, especially after 16 December. So mid-December to mid-January is going to be a brilliant transit for you. but you will have to let go of a part of your personality, and you will have to accept the new change. This new change is going to be the key for your success. Overall, you will have to just take care of any injury on the head or any you know, while you're shaving or while you're doing your daily activity, just ensure that there is a chance of a blood loss from the head or a face region. So don't fall. Be careful. Small accidents can create trouble. Mars and Ketu also means that physically you might not bother. So don't exhaust yourself. Don't exhaust your energy. Rather, because Saturn is in the third house, go slow. Your success lies in a proper planning and a proper execution of the plan with a lot of patience. Sagittarius Ascendant. Now, in case of Sagittarius Ascendant, Mars goes in the 12th house. Now, this is really a positive placement for Mars. It shows a lot of changes will come in your life because your fifth lord goes in the 12th house. And once Sun moves in your first house, you will see a great Buddhaditya Yoga being formed. 9th lord, 10th lord and 7th lord are together. No major negative planets coming in the Kendra Bhava for you in the central houses in the 1, 4, 7 and 10. And this is a very, very strong and positive significance. This shows that for Sagittarius Ascendant, Mars transit in the 12th house shows control on the losses. Ketu was like reckless loss. Ketu was like losing control of self, improper sleep. 12th house also means donation. So when Mars goes in that house, if you start donating, especially to the needy people connected with police force, with army, to the families of deceased, martyred soldiers, if you just help in any kind, you will see that the loss in your life will convert into gains. Mars movement in the 12th house is also good for people who want to travel overseas. Yes, considering all the practical scenario that we see in the modern world, at least it shows that suddenly your plans can change and you will have to work accordingly. But in case you see that movement is possible, then for people who are waiting for visa, who are waiting to move into a foreign country, will see good results, will see a proper movement. Also, it is good time for students, because for students it shows that they will give up a lot of useless activity and you will have to focus on losses. You will have to cover up for what you have missed. So this transit is actually a transit of recovery for Sagittarius Ascendant, where it recovers most of the losses for you, but only after 16th of December. Till that time, you will just need to wait and watch. Don't waste your energy. Don't daydream. Try to be as practical as possible and you will see a wonderful month ahead. Capricorn Ascendant. For Capricorn Ascendant, Mars will move in the 11th house. Now, this means that movement of Mars in the 11th house, 4th lord going in the 11th house, health of mother can create some impact. With Mars and Ketu in the 11th house, have a filter on whom you meet, what kind of network circle you have. Because Mars and Ketu can actually cut down on the source of income for a very certain category of people whose 10th house is badly affected. This can indicate loss of job. But with Mars and Ketu, because Mars goes in its own house, it also means recovery of the lost money. Maybe you are working for a long time with a salary that is way less than what your qualification is. And with this Mars transit, if you try, you will get a better chance, better source of income. It's not going to shoot things to the sky, but it is at least going to recover few things. It is a transit of gain. 11th lord coming in 11th house fills the gap. It is like a thirsty person gets water. So it's a brilliant transit for you. Saturn in the first house alone, Jupiter in the second house. Everything seems to be positive for Capricorn Ascendant. Just that there will be a bit of, I will say, a bit of disappointment, because things will not go exactly the way you planned, but that's okay. Take it as life's gift. Fourth house is the Sukha Bhav. It goes in the 11th house And after the eclipse, after the sun moves in the 12th house, you will see that few expectations will be cut down, few checks will happen, few things here and there, small adjustments, and you will see the next one and a half month as a very transforming month for you, a month where you are somehow adjusting. The kind of adjustment you were waiting for so long will now happen. This was the time when your ascendant was waiting, because after all, your ascendant is Capricorn, and that's the place where Mars gets exalted. So Mars likes your ascendant. So Mars will never work against your ascendant. It's also a Yoga Karaka planet for you, 4th and 11th Lord. So for Capricorn, I will say this is one of the best transit. Make the best use of it, but just don't just become a slave of your expectations. Be ready for change, because for things you want to get, you will have to give up few things that you already have. Aquarius ascendant. For Aquarius ascendant, Mars transit will happen in the 10th house, and along with Mars and Ketu, this definitely shows a slight detachment in the workplace. Maybe you will not get as many appreciation, but now all those gaps are slowly going to fill itself, especially after 16th of December. People looking out for a big career change, designation change, can expect some positive outcome while Mars moves into this particular house. Remember, Jupiter is now in your first house in the Martian Nakshatra. So, any kind of desperate attempt to bring things under your control will not work in your favor. Rather, you will have to work towards surrender. See, 10th house is the house of karma, and Mars and Ketu will be in Anuradha Nakshatra the moment Sun will be in your 11th house. Why Sun's Surya movement is important? Because Sun rules your 7th house, and 7th house is the feedback from the surroundings. It's the circumstances in your life. So your designation, your career will act according to what people have to say. So don't feel negative when you get a negative feedback, but you will have to work towards fulfilling your gap. So your critics should be, you should be very close to your critics and listen to them, because then it will be giving you the necessary avenues for correction and improvement. Mars transit in the sign of Scorpio for Aquarius ascendant is the time when a major shift in career will happen, especially if you are going under Mars or Ketu Mahadasha or Antaradasha, and you will see a real positive transformation. Make the best use of it. Pisces ascendant. Now, in case of Pisces ascendant, Mars will move in the 9th house. This again shows a Dharma Yuddha. This shows that your belief system will once again come back to you. With Ketu in the 9th house, it was more like explore new things. But when Mars moves in the 9th house, it shows that once again you will come back to your roots. You will come back to your own basic understanding. And this creates a lot of belief, a lot of confidence. For Pisces ascendant, this Mars transit fights the unnecessary Rahu's energy in the 3rd house and stabilizes your destiny. Mars and Ketu also means you need to visit some very old Hanuman temple wherever it is possible and whenever it is possible. At least plan during this transit. After 16th of December, when Sun moves out of the Scorpio zodiac sign, things will become very positive for you. This is a destiny altering transit. This transit can give you a lot of positive energy, so you can plan your year ahead. And when Mars moves out of the Scorpio zodiac sign, and once it goes and meets Venus, it definitely shows a real experiment with your career. 9th house also means long distance travel and professional education. So people who are going to take long distance travel or who are going to plan your education need to plan very carefully, because your decision must fill your gaps, not fulfill your expectations. So try to cover up for the losses in the past. Try to cover up for the deficit, and then you will see that Mars transit will actually work in your favor. 9th Lord coming in 9th house is considered to be one of the best transit, and this is when destiny changes. This is when your direction of life changes. This is like a nodal transit. That means this is like a junction. From here, your life can take any turn. You need to ensure that your turn is always in the positive direction, and you will have to give a lot of thoughts, because 1st Lord is in 12th house in Martian Nakshatra of Dhanishta. So focus more on good deeds, follow the Dharma, and you will see that you will be in the right path. So that was a brief analysis for all ascendant on Mars transit in the sign of Scorpio. Remember, this is a generic analysis. A lot of things will depend on your own horoscope. This is just a YouTube video. So just try to get some guidance out of this. And in case you are in some trouble, then you will need a proper consultation from any learned astrologer. I hope you like this video. Share the video among family and friends. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, namaste.